If you're looking to implement power over Ethernet in your home network, can you use any Ethernet cable you have on hand? Well, honestly, I wish it was that easy. There are a few things you need to verify before using an Ethernet cable for PoE, and that's exactly what we're going to be talking about in today's episode from Network from Home. One thing I want to get out of the way right from the start here is that you don't need different versions of Ethernet cables for different versions of PoE. Whether you're implementing PoE, PoE Plus, PoE Plus+, all you need to do is you need to make sure that your Ethernet cables are compatible with PoE and they can be used for any of these versions that you're implementing. All right, with that out of the way, what are some of the things we need to verify about our Ethernet cables if we want to use them for PoE? The first thing we need to look at is the category of Ethernet cable. We need to make sure that we're using Cat 5e Ethernet cables or above. The category of Ethernet cable, it basically just refers to the version of Ethernet cable you're using. So the higher numbers, the higher categories, refer to the more recent versions of Ethernet cables that are developed. A general rule of thumb is the higher the category, the more data the cable can transfer. So what we need to verify is just make sure we're using Cat 5e, Cat 6, Cat 8, any of those versions will be fine for PoE. So how do we figure out the category of Ethernet cable that we have? Well, it might be tough to see, but on the side of the Ethernet cable, there is printed verbiage. And what this will tell you is in here, it will say Cat, and then it will give you the Cat of Ethernet cable that you have. I'll put a screenshot up here to show you what this Ethernet cable says. This looks like it is a Cat 5e cable, so I know I'm fine to use it for PoE. It checks the box there. There are other things we need to look at, but that first step is just making sure you have Cat 5e or above. I'll say that at this point, the vast majority of Ethernet cables are Cat 5e and above, so this should be a layup for you. All of the cables you have in your home network, I'm willing to bet will be Cat 5e, Cat 6, maybe even Cat 8 if you bought recent Ethernet cables. All right, the easy part is out of the way. Here's where things get a little bit more complicated. The next thing and the most important thing you need to verify is that your Ethernet cables are made up of all copper wires. In order to understand why this is important, let's refresh what's actually happening with PoE. In normal data communications using an Ethernet cable that's not used for PoE, you're sending pulses of electricity through those wires between the devices so that they can communicate with each other. With PoE, you're still sending the data along the cable to the two devices, but on top of that, you're providing a steady stream of power through the cable to the other device so that way it can be powered on. So basically, the difference between a normal data communication and a PoE communication is that with PoE, you have additional power and additional electricity traveling through the Ethernet cable. The more electricity traveling through the cable, the hotter that cable will get. And if you're not using the right material, if you don't have copper inside those Ethernet cables, it can lead to some safety issues. Unfortunately, we can't assume that all of the wires inside of our Ethernet cables are all copper, because many cheaper Ethernet cables are made of CCA or copper clad aluminum wires. I will admit that I am guilty of this. Usually when buying Ethernet cables, I buy the cheapest ones I can find. But in many of these cases, these wires are made of CCA and are not fully copper. The main reason why we want to steer away from copper clad aluminum wires inside our Ethernet cables when we're implementing PoE is because aluminum has a much higher resistance than copper. What does this mean? This means that with the additional electricity that you're passing through the cable when you're using PoE, it results in a much higher temperature, and these copper clad aluminum wires will heat up. They can cause your PoE injector or PoE switch to fail. They can cause your device on the other end to not get enough power, and this will cause the device to restart or just power off. And in a worst case scenario, it could even potentially start a fire. Copper, on the other hand, has much less resistance than aluminum. It can handle that additional electricity being passed through the cable without any issues, and that's why we need to verify that our cables have copper wires inside of them. Okay, so how do we tell if our Ethernet cables have copper wires or CCA wires inside of them? Well, ideally, we'd be able to follow the same method as before. We could look at the writing on the Ethernet cable itself, and it would tell us. But unfortunately, it's not that easy. What I did is I looked at all the Ethernet cables that I had, and I found very inconsistent results. For example, some Ethernet cables would tell me what the wires are inside the cable. For example, this on the side of it, it says printed, it says CCA. So I know that it's copper clad aluminum and I can't use this for PoE. Another example is I know this Ethernet cable has been used for PoE. On the side of the cable, we're looking for either CU, bare copper, pure copper. It doesn't say anything on the printing on the cable. I know it's been used for PoE, so I know it works and it has copper wires in it, but you wouldn't be able to tell just looking at the cable and reading the side of it. Herein lies the challenge when it comes to determining if your Ethernet cables have copper wires or not. So what should you do in these circumstances? Well, honestly, in these cases, I think it's almost better to just buy new Ethernet cables that you know have copper wires. It's not worth the risk of taking a chance on an Ethernet cable you're not sure about, so buying new wires is your best bet. I'll include a link in the description to some Ethernet cables that I've used before that I know have copper wires. And then maybe what you want to do is, once you receive those cables, maybe you want to mark them a certain way. You can put some painter's tape or other tape around them just to indicate that they have copper wires, so you know if you're ever moving them around in the future, you know that you can use them for PoE. There's some Ethernet cable testers online that will tell you if a cable can be used for PoE or not, but honestly, those cost more than if you were to buy multiple Ethernet cables that have all copper wires. So from my perspective, it makes more financial sense to just buy new Ethernet cables that you know have copper wires. Of course, the game has changed here. If you have a spool of several hundred feet of Ethernet cable in your home, you haven't used it yet, and you make your own Ethernet cables, then maybe you want to get a tester so you're not wasting all of those yards of Ethernet cable. But honestly, once you've verified that you have a Cat5e cable or above, and your Ethernet cable is made of all copper wires, those are the two main hitters here. Some other considerations, people might ask the question, should you go with shielded or unshielded Ethernet cables? Honestly, the same rules apply here to standard deployments where you're just using Ethernet cables for data. Using PoE doesn't mean you should use unshielded or shielded. Again, in most cases, you'll be fine with an unshielded Ethernet cable. You'll just want to use shielded Ethernet cables whenever you're implementing that Ethernet cable in environments with heavy machinery or environments where you're running the cable near electrical wire and you might get some electromagnetic interference. Those are probably the only cases where you need to use shielded Ethernet cables. The last consideration here is that if you're implementing a PoE device outside, this is very common for security cameras, you'll want to make sure that the Ethernet cable you're buying is UV rated. It will say UV on the side of the cable, or just make sure you buy a new Ethernet cable that's rated for ultraviolet light protection. This basically just protects the cable from sunlight and makes sure that it won't degrade over time while it's outside. At this point, you have as much knowledge as you need to use Ethernet cables for PoE. I'd love to see in the comments section if you had as much frustration as I did when trying to determine if your Ethernet cables are made of copper wires or not. As always, thanks for checking out this episode from Network From Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.